I'm actually doing a PhD in gender and performance at the moment, so this is embodied research, as we call it in academia.
How is that helping? As in,
I honestly don't think this is helping anyone. Well, it's sort of early stages, really, but my background is in design. I've been working as a theatre designer for about the last 10, 15 years. Before that, I was kind of performing a little bit, and I've just kind of decided to get back into putting myself into the work a bit more. And I'm studying gender and performance, and I'm really interested in the drag king and non-binary culture that's sort of just exploded in the last couple of years, at the same time as we're having this amazing conversation culturally, globally, about gender. This is going to be one of the most significant paradigm shifts of the 21st century, the way we think about gender. And at the moment, I think it's our last best hope, our only hope, against the Trumpocalypse. Because if you dismantle the gender binary, then you dismantle patriarchy, you dismantle capitalism, and that's how we're going to bring them down. I guess I've been kind of following it for a few years, but I'm only kind of diving into it fairly recently because of the PhD. The PhD was basically an excuse to just hang out in drag bars and get paid for it.
Right,
pretty sweet. You should ask Johnny Cashback some questions.
Johnny Cashback. Let us know what it's
Johnny Cashback.
I work in a theatre, I work in retail there, and then I'm a musician in my spare time, like it's a hobby.
When did you first get into
drag? Today. No, not really. I don't know, you should see me in real life, it's not that different, I know. It was my first sort of drag king performance, as it were, but it's not men's clothes, no big deal for me.
We do play together in a band,
we were sort of introduced as our band tonight, but we were missing one member.
We've done this before a bit, but with basically just without Blicky.
I've been doing open mics for about 5 years or something, I think, and because I'm sort of like a folk musician, and so for me, the whole thing behind it, which what was really nice about tonight as well, is it's that whole thing about people being together and supporting each other, and that's what folk music is, and that's what any music kind of is, you know. As much as it was a competition, it didn't really feel like that. It was more about people supporting each other and a minority community especially, there's something about, you know, all being together and all sharing something and entertaining each other. Like, that's music in its very primary, most beautiful form, I think. And that's what I liked about it.
Our coming out situation. When did we first come out as a band? Or
When did you first come out as yourself? So I'm not too sure, obviously, what you
I was never in a closet. It was more like, you know those glass-fronted display cabinets, cabinets that your gran has, you know, where it's you sort of go surprise and everyone goes nah. But it's kind of different for me anyway, because I identify as bisexual, so it was never I don't know. I never really had a whole big kind of coming out kind of thing, you know. But I don't know about you.
Kind of a long story and kind of not a long story. I identify as trans, non-binary, trans little star. It always seems like a little wink. I like the little. But I think I didn't really have the words for that until quite recently, because those words didn't really, those conversations didn't really exist outside of kind of niche academia. So I think like it was something I knew about myself like forever, but also then there was this kind of awkward phase of being with men and sort of, yeah, I sort of did end up kind of painting myself into a corner that then turned into a closet, then turned into a massive wardrobe, then turned into Narnia. I was in Narnia for a few years, and you know at the end of Narnia when they sort of all kind of, they just like forget that they've ever been anything else and they all think they were kings and queens and stuff. But it was sort of the opposite, like I forgot that that I was a king. I sort of fell out of the closet again and just was like, why did I forget all of that really important stuff? That was an articulate telling of coming out story, wasn't it?
Is that like empowering for
the
both of you in the sense of saying you're coming out? Is that both empowering moment for you, or is it
another day? Another day at the office.
I think what's most empowering is that it wasn't a big deal. Like it was that kind of, you know, says a lot about society and like you know, your relationships with people and stuff like that. And like I don't know, if it had been a big deal, then I don't know, that would have said like, you know, not, it wouldn't have quite been as powerful somehow. I don't know if that makes any sense. I don't know.
I think I told my parents, I told my mum that I like women, like sort of in my early 20s probably, and she was a bit like, whatever. And then I actually told my parents about the whole trans thing last year. I had to engineer that quite carefully. I took them to see a play that I'd worked on called Rotterdam. Plug. Everyone should go and see Rotterdam, because Rotterdam's a really good Olivia Award winning play in the West End next month. The Arts Theatre.
That was smooth.
Square,
that
yeah.
was seamless, man. That was there.
And it plays from the June the 21st to July the 15th, and tickets are on sale now. But yeah, I invited my parents to come and see the play, and then I sent them an email afterwards saying, you know, that play we all watched. Yeah, it was a very British moment for all of us. I'm an open book. Too open.
I have a dog bite on my arse. I got bitten by a dog the other day.
I very nobly offered somebody stranded on the night of Saturday when bad shit went down and some dicks decided to fuck shit up. I very nobly offered a friend my bed, and then I very ignobly remembered that I left my vibrator in said bed. But you know, you've got to find love where you can, haven't you?
Just want to stay in and watch movies. I guess you think